Faced with plummeting enrollment and deteriorating finances, the chancellor at Southern Illinois University is proposing a radical reorganization that has spurred fierce backlash from many faculty members and stoked broad confusion about how it would be implemented. SU Carbondale Chancellor Carlo Montemagno is pushing to eliminate academic departments and department heads, a highly unorthodox move that eschews the customary structures of higher education. In its place, he wants to introduce a hierarchy of colleges, schools, and programs that would move related areas of study under the same roofs and foster easier collaboration. Part of the aim, Montemagno acknowledged, is to save money. The Carbondale campus finances are so shaky that it borrowed from its sister school in Edwardsville during the state's two-year budget gridlock that starved it of cash. Montemagno said eliminating department heads would save $2.3 million a year, but he also sees the reorganization as an opportunity to make the university's academic offerings more attractive to students in an increasingly competitive college landscape and to chart a more self-sufficient course for SU that is less dependent on money from Springfield. The responses from faculty have been divided. SIU's Faculty Senate recently approved a resolution opposing the move, but that vote was split 19-11. Many faculty members said they agree that some revamping is long overdue, and some have said they support the plan. Others say they have not had sufficient input or time to evaluate the chancellor's strategy and feel eliminating departments will unleash complications. Montemagno said he wanted a final draft of the plan in place by February and the reorganization to launch by summer 2018, an ambitious timetable in the often sclerotic world of academia. By any comparison, the plan is as bold as it is unorthodox. Montemagno and others say they are not aware of any other public research university in the country that has successfully dissolved whole departments. The chancellor, an engineer who arrived at SU in July after working in teaching and administrative roles at the University of Alberta, said that he understood his proposal was sweeping and the time frame abrupt, but that SIU's recent struggles have left him little option. Reorganizing without addressing our current structural and financial inefficiencies is tantamount to rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic. SU Carbondale Chancellor Carlo Montemagno. SIU's first-time freshman classes declined from 2,177 in fall 2015 to 1,319, a drop of nearly 40%. Data show, I needed to do something drastic, otherwise I wasn't going to be able to support the programs that we had, and I was going to put myself into a crisis mode. Montemagno said in a recent interview, the prospect of eliminating departments is a sticky one and many details have yet to be clarified. Questions remain over issues like how academic tenure will work and whether faculty members will retain ultimate control over curricular decisions. Some faculty members also said they were pondering who would assume the administrative duties that usually fall to the department heads. I think if things can be done in a productive manner, it can be good, said James McLean, an associate professor of physiology in the School of Medicine. But if this is done inappropriately and it causes faculty to be disgruntled and look elsewhere, that's not good for us. Plenty of dissatisfaction has emerged. We in the Faculty Association will have no objection if faculty in any given area determine that the Chancellor's school model works for them, Dave Johnson, Faculty Association president, wrote in a blog post this month. What we object to is a unilateral decision to eliminate all academic departments, a decision that was made without consultation with faculty and is apparently being maintained in the face of objections from faculty. Synergy is the word Montemagno returns to often when detailing his vision for Carbondale's academic operations. Montemagno first announced his plans to do away with departments during his State of the University address in September. He said he reviewed SIU's offerings and found similar courses were scattered across different departments and academic majors were incongruous with their departments. SIU's undergraduate major in hospitality and tourism administration, for instance, is housed under the College of Agricultural Sciences. it would be a better fit under the College of Business, he said. It became obvious that we were doing the right things, but it wasn't being packaged so that people on the outside could see it, and we weren't taking advantage of the synergy that you would get from people in these adjacent areas working together, Montemagno said. Currently there are 42 academic departments within 8 colleges at Southern Illinois. The schools of law and medicine are separate. Montemagno's most recent draft of the plan would reduce the number of colleges to 5. Instead of academic departments, there would be 18 schools, each of which would contain several programs with an array of degrees. As an example, the business college would include schools of accountancy and finance, and of management and marketing. There would be 4 divisions in the accountancy school offering 15 major, graduate, certification and minor degrees. The schools of medicine, law and education would be their own entities, not under the purview of a college, according to the draft. The divisions are most akin to what constitutes a department, while the work of a school director would be most similar to the responsibilities of a department head, Montemagno said. The leadership structure would look similar. Colleges would be led by deans, schools and divisions all would have their own directors. But Montemagno said Sue could realize the $2.3 million in savings by reducing the number of deans, eliminating some associate dean positions and funneling the main duties of a department chair to fewer people. School directors would receive additional compensation for taking on more work. Montemagno said nothing short of deconstructing and rebuilding SIU's academics will fix the disorganization. Reorganizing without addressing our current structural and financial inefficiencies is tantamount to rearranging the deck chairs on the Titanic, he said in a university address on November 17. In his first detailed presentation of the reorganization plan in October, he described SU enrollment as being in free fall. Total enrollment dropped nearly 16% in the past 3 years. He also pointed to the state budget impasse, which compelled borrowing from the Edwardsville campus and continues to disrupt school finances. Why is this occurring? It's occurring because we are not offering programs that are distinctive and relevant to today's students, Montemagno said at the time. As we try to correct it, we face limited resources, declining faculty numbers, and no help from the state. Some professors support the idea. Kathleen Qualas, president of the Faculty Senate, said years long losses in faculty and staff hit SIU's departments unevenly, often leaving too few people to teach courses and tackle administrative tasks. We're still trying to offer the same curriculum we offered back when we had 24,000 students, said Qualas, a psychology professor. SIU's fall enrollment sits at 14,554. More broadly, Qualas said the chancellor's plans offer a chance to reinvent SU after years of decline. It feels like we are renovating a really old house that has lots of little rooms in it, Qualas said. The chancellor's trying to make it more open concept. Ultimately, it's going to be a little chaotic and dirty and uncomfortable for a while as we do that, but the kids have left home and we don't need 20 bedrooms. McLean said he was wary of the plan at first. The chancellor's first version involved moving science programs out of the medical school, which McLean said would have affected accreditation and made it harder to obtain National Institute of Health grants. That idea has since been scrapped. Now, he said, some of his concerns center upon academic leadership. There's a disconnect between what the chancellor thinks department chairs or program directors should do and what they actually do, based on my experience, McLean said. If his goal is to replace administrative assistants who do that work so that the chairman is free to not have to do that, then that's another part of the story. But that takes additional resources, and the point of these reorganizations is to save resources for something else, Montemagno said. The plan was aimed at jump-starting recruitment efforts for the 2019 incoming class, as well as beginning a longer-term effort to reach an ideal enrollment of 18,300 students. But to get there, he will have to win over skeptics, including Johnson, the Faculty Association President, the Chancellor's plan is already producing at least as much concern and confusion as excitement or interest. Johnson wrote, "What the Chancellor is asking us to do is to bet that this confusion and disruption will pay off in the long run. But in the absence of models or other forms of evidence, this seems a very risky bet indeed." Rhodes at ChicagoTribune.com. Twitter. At Rhodes underscore Don. Related university students detail pain of budget stalemate. Related standard poor's downgrades NEIU, SU and University of Illinois. Related with Illinois budget deal secured, public universities still face challenges.